Well, hello and welcome to what amounts to football heaven. It doesn't get a whole lot better than this. The conditions are utopian. The sky is blue and the players are with us for a football match so widely and keenly anticipated. Truly, this is pristine. And the level of expectation and excitement is reflected in the smiling faces of the crowd. They know it means so much, and they also experience between them a great sense of privilege at being able to attend this most special of games. We have terrific scenes in front of us at the Estádio do Dragão, one of the biggest venues in Portugal. Has got the juices flowing, and now this. This is the perfect game for all parties, not least the neutrals who've just come to enjoy it.
Yes, Peter, it's a shame it's only a friendly, but then again, that may help us see a more expressive attacking contest. And I'd be prepared to settle for a clash of lesser intensity in favour of lots of flair, skill and plenty of tricks and a few goals. I suspect I've probably overstretched my level of greed here.
Away.
Sympathy here because I think he might have been slightly unsighted. However, credit where it's due, it's still a fine finish from a tight spot.
Hungary trail at this early stage. How will they respond? And he has been fouled there. Gets away from his opponent, battles to win it back.
Through.
And now the breakaway. Chip through.
Well, I'm not quite sure he needed to hold up play quite as much as he did then. A couple of his teammates were very annoyed.
He came in hard, very hard.
Tries to stroke it through. Well read, he's sorted that out. Goes long. Pass needed to be better than that, and he knows it. All the way back, and they start again. Keeper's got good distance on that. He's certainly caught him there, it's a free kick. He'll hit it! Just a whisker away. Great strength, too strong for his opponent. Oh, good interception. Good progress he's made on the ball. Where to next? Oh, well intercepted. Really alert to the danger. Big chance! Oh, no shortage of confidence there.
Well, the run was really impressive. The finish was impressive.
It's half-time.
And here we are, off they go for half-time. The breakthrough did indeed come in the first half, but there has only been that one goal, which is very, very tight.
Well, they showed glimpses of some wonderful football to go in with the lead at half-time, and that's definitely pleased the fans. I think they'll be looking to keep this intensity up now in the second half.
France head for the dressing room in possession of a 1-0 lead. Well, we're already into the second period. France carrying a one-goal lead. There's a long ball. Done very well to intervene. And it's played forward. Did really well to intervene and dispel the growing danger. Goes for goal! They've done it! Two up now, and they are cruising. That is about as cool as they come. He picked his spot expertly.
Well, I think two keepers would have had a hard time keeping that one out, never mind one. There was real venom in the striker and clear composure from the placement.
France get themselves a two-goal cushion.
Well, at 1-0, this contest was still nicely poised, but now that it's gone to two, mindsets are affected a lot more. Winning belief one way and that losing feeling the other.
Hungary get it back again. To thread it through. A little accusatory stare there tells the whole story.
That was just poor decision making and a weak execution.
Oh. by two and just about into the home straight. Looks to dink one in.
Keeper's ball.
It's an untidy challenge. Free kick given. Gorgeous control there. It's a fabulous position. Oh, that's a foul, and the whistle's gone.
Well, I think the alternative was to stand there and do nothing while he tried to score, and obviously he's not going to allow that, Peter, is he?
Turns and goes back. There goes the final whistle. France always looked the more driven side, probably the better side, and nobody is arguing about the results. Your reflections then, Jim?
France showed us why it's so important to seize the initiative. Once in front, they grew in belief and rarely looked at risk.
So that's it for today. Thank you, Jim, and good afternoon all.